little bit more.
Are you gonna look into the camera, not look into yourself? Because I know you're just so like. Hey guys, this is Safina, and you are watching A King's Love Convos. You're the petty brother that I didn't pray for, but I got anyway. I am with Damon, and Damon has his own channel, right? GTR TV. It's pretty dope, so make sure you check it out. But me and Damon known each other for
almost 4 years now.
What? Yeah. For real?
Yeah, 2013. That's what I mentioned.
That's 3 years.
Almost four. No. Your calendar go forward or backward?
What?
Does your calendar go backward or forward?
Forward.
Well, I'm closing it on four then.
It just turned 2016.
It don't matter.
Yes, it does matter.
It does not matter.
Yes, it does. You have a problem with your...
Okay. All right. 3 years.
Thank you. You don't be mad at me because you don't
know how to
do that.
3 years. Okay.
Today, we are going to just be doing a video and talking about...
Intimacy.
Intimacy with the Lord.
With God.
Hallelujah. So, stay tuned and...
I don't know.
Keep watching.
Don't click off.
The floor is yours, brother.
One thing that I've learned is that there's lessons that God wants to teach you every day, all the time. Amen. And because you don't speak to him or you ignore him for that day, you may not be doing purpose, but like if you don't speak to him, you kind of miss it. Like the lessons are there, or people say like, oh, God isn't speaking or whatever, God isn't talking to me. It's like he could be talking, your ear just isn't really tuned into him because you don't intentionally tune it into him. Whereas like every day I want to hear what he has to say.
Yeah.
And when you want it, that's the thing about God, is like, if you want to hear from him, he will talk. Like, he's waiting for you, like, oh, you do? Okay, I got you, you know?
One time, like, God gave me this analogy of, like, no one whispers secrets from across the room. So, if I want to tell Damon a secret, right? Like, and if we're at a party, I can't whisper it across the room. I have to get close to Damon, and I have to be here and to be able to whisper it to him. So I think it's the same thing with God. Like, if you want to hear his voice, it's just like, okay, we want all of these answers and we want like, okay, yeah, God, write it in the sky for me. But it's like, God wants that relationship, like that close intimacy, that friendship, that relationship.
I think a lot of people don't think that that's possible though. I think that's what stops people. Like, if I pray and he doesn't answer, then I mean, you're not real. Like, so I think it's always a fear of people to kind of put him on that level. The more time that you put into it, the more time that you invest in it, the better it's gonna be.
I always think about like, in the Bible, it's like the first and greatest command was to love the Lord God with all your heart, soul, and strength, and to love people as though you love yourself. So it's like, we could be doing so much stuff. Like, we could be doing ministry. We could be doing all of the right Christian stuff. Like, I'm reading my Bible every day. I'm praying every day. I'm going to church every Sunday. I serve in these ministries. But it's like, I feel like the reason why we get burnt out or the reason why we get bored is because a lot of times the motive and the heart behind it is not love. It's not like, God, I love you so much, so I want to serve you, or I want to do these things because I'm so in love with you. Like, it's like a different motivation. So it's like, if I have a boyfriend, he's calling me and texting me, and he's only doing it because he's like, all right, I don't want to hear her mouth. Or, you know, let me make sure I, you know, tell her she's beautiful because, you know, I don't want her nagging me later on. And, you know, like, I wouldn't want that. So I think it's the same thing with God. It's just like, there's a reason why he said the first and greatest commandment. It could have been anything. The first and greatest commandment could have been, you know,
Pay your tithes.
It could have been anything, but God, that's his number one thing, like, is love. It's like having a permanent best friend.
For real.
Like, a permanent, and a fire, but a perfect best friend, too. It's like, this best friend can never fail you, can never lie to you, like, is your protector, is your provider, is your
closer than
comforter, is just everything wrapped into one. And I think, like, that's the place that, he wants us to get to, and that I want, you know, other people to get to. It's just like that intimacy. That intimacy is so dope.
You were talking about, you know, being in relationship with God, and to me, like, even those commandments, like love God and love your neighbor, whatever, like, it just shows you relationships. Like, that's really the most important thing to him. That's why people have that whole, like, it's not religion, it's relationship kind of thing going on, the movement.
But I feel like that needs a little, like...
I don't like that saying.
Me neither.
I don't like that saying because...
That's not 100% biblical. No, because in James, it says what true religion is.
What it
says. It says that true religion is that you care for the widows mm-hmm. and the orphans. Exactly. And that you stay spotless and blameless from this world.
That's what religion
is. So that's
is.
What religion is. So this whole, like, it's not religion, it's relationship. Yeah. Technically, that's not really biblical.
Yeah, it's not. What's crazy is that the definition of religion is still relationship.
Right.
Because it's still taking care of orphans and taking care of widows, you know, and being spotless in, what is it, like sexually, like pure or whatever?
Right, or just being spotless from the world. Like, you keep yourself clean from the world's way of doing things and the world's way of thinking.
But like, I don't know, God to me puts such a high emphasis on relationship that there's really no other way to go about it.
Yeah.
That's why when you'll see people that, like, they go to church all the time, but nothing in them has changed or they're still the same, they don't have that. What can I even compare it to? I'm just thinking about, like, you know, that one person's like, oh yeah, you're like my best friend, and you're like, nah, I don't even know you like that. Like,
for me, it makes me think of, like, how, you know, the Bible says, like, he is a jealous God all throughout the Old Testament, where, like, first of all, God didn't play. Like, when it came to idolatry, which is, like, when they used to worship these false gods, lowercase g, and they would, you know, sacrifice their children and sacrifice, you know, burn incense to these false gods. Like, God destroyed nations over idolatry. So I think that in and of itself, like, shows how passionate he is for his children and how passionate, like, you see how you get jealous if somebody's talking to your man? Like, that's...
times
and how
10.
You ready to, like...
Times 7.
Lose your salvation? That's God times a trillion. Like, right. God is so jealous for us. So that in and of itself, I think, is another testament to how passionate he is about us having relationship. And I also think about, too, I think it was in Isaiah, the children of Israel, like, they were doing all of these things. Like, they were having all of these festivals. They were, like... just going through the motions, basically, like doing the rituals. And he was just like, yeah, you're doing all these rituals, but like, your heart is evil. Y'all gossiping about each other. Yeah, y'all still
like
murdering.
My name is on your tongue, but your hearts are far away
exactly,
from
me. Exactly. Oh, that was really bad. All right. But yeah.
Sometimes I've done stuff wrong and I know I don't deserve to really hear his voice. I don't deserve for him to talk to me. He's still there chilling, like, bring it back in, you know?
Yeah.
So, for the person who feels like, oh, I have to do too many things or I've done too many wrong things or whatever. Like, I was an atheist. Like, I used to curse his name and get people to walk away from Christianity.
Wait, why were you an atheist?
Because my grandfather died when I was young. Mm-hmm. And I didn't have anybody explain that to me. So I blamed God and just distanced myself from him as much as I could. And I was young. I was like 11. And that went up until I was 20. Yeah. End of 20. I just made a decision. I remember, like, exactly how I felt because I was blaming him. I was laying in the bed crying. Like, my pillow was wet with tears of me just crying. I love my grandfather. And I gave up on God from there. And he, you know, it's funny that I even say that because my grandmother believes in God. And I told her this around the time, probably a little bit before I got saved. And she was like, do I believe in God? I was like, no, I don't believe in no God. And she was like, well, he believes in you. And I was like, okay, that's nice for you. So even for a person who may have, like, stumbled on this video and you don't know God at all, and you don't really, you might not even care to know who God is, but, like, when I tell you that love that he has for you is on some whole other level, like, I'm telling you, like, I was running away from, like, people who grew up with me are like, you got saved? Like,
weed smoking,
right? There's a you of all people. I would never, like, walk away from him, and I can't because it's really like falling in love with somebody and you giving them everything. You have your heart. And you want to be able to give your heart to somebody. I've given my heart to him, and it's in the safest place. Like, even if I get hurt throughout my walk with God, even if times get bad, even if I don't have everything that I want, I know that my heart is in the safest possible place, and that every time something goes wrong, I can always turn back to him. Like, I don't think I've ever had anybody that I could count on 100%, and I know that I could count on him just from our relationship, you know, just from our conversations, just from how he's healed me from stuff that hurt me before. And, like, if you feel like you don't know him or you feel like you're far away from him, like, you have to just give him the opportunity. Boy, it's not that important. Give him the chance to show who he is. Because he's not what you see in these churches, or he's not always what you see in how people act. And when you see Christians and they're back outside cursing and want to fight each other and doing all this other stuff, like, that's not him. It's not a good representation of who he is. Like, his love, you haven't seen his love. Like, this is the thing, is like, even if we try to give a good example, even if I show you love, let's say you do something mean to me and I forgive you or whatever, like, even my forgiveness still has a little bit of bitterness and a little bit of anger, but his is on a whole, like, it's not, you can't comprehend it, how much he cares for you, how much passion he has for you, how much that he wants you to be there. Like I said, I've sinned and I've done wrong things, and he still keeps pulling me And I don't always know how to handle that, you know, like just knowing that no matter what I do, he's still like, I still love you. I still want to pull you back. And I don't like, he forgets it so fast and accepts you. And I just want you to be able to feel that, whoever's watching it. And that's all I got.
See, I'm about to cry.
I'm done. I was about to cry and I didn't want to cry, so I stopped talking.
Why? Look at
that. Nah, I'm good. Just know it's real of it and you can have it too.
Amen. You know the scripture that says it's God's love and kindness that draws a man into repentance. And I know for me, like I was in this situation, I was in a relationship 4 years. It was like an abusive, crazy, crazy relationship. And I remember just feeling so trapped and feeling like, just feeling hopeless and trapped. And like we had gotten to an argument. It was a crazy argument because, you know, crazy relationships, you have crazy arguments. And I remember I was crying for the billionth time. And I was just so like, I felt like I was at my wit's end. Like I was bawling, I was crying. And I remember like just crying out to God. And at the time I didn't see it as me crying out to God. And God, I don't know. I know I don't talk to you. I know I don't pray. Like I know I probably not living right, but I just need you to get me out of this situation. Something that always like gets to me is he didn't say, oh, now, you know, now you want me after you was, you know, sinning and after you were, you know, with this person, like now you want to turn to me. Like it was none of that. Like it was just, he came, I called, he came. And from there, like it wasn't an overnight process, but from there he just started to work. And to see where I am now compared to where I was 4 or 5 years ago is only God could do that. Like only God can do that. And so to me, that's always what melts my heart when I think about who God is. And like you said, sometimes people see other Christians or bad representations of who God is, and it taints the witness.
But you won't find out unless you find out for yourself. Because we can say everything that we're saying. Mm-hmm. And I remember God showed me this a long time ago, and I've always wanted to do a video about this, but I've never gotten around to it.
Oh, look at God.
if I give, let's say I give Safina a piece of paper, right? And I'm looking at like this great piece of art, and I'm just sitting here, and I'm like, all right, Safina got trees in the back and a sunset. And she could draw exactly what I'm saying. And then when I show her the picture, what I show her could be way better than whatever it is that she drew, or something that she couldn't even really see it like that, or the colors could be mixed just in a whole different way. And that's the same way it is with me even telling you what my relationship with God is like. It's like she can paint a picture from what I say, but she can't fully experience what it is that I'm seeing, you know, unless she can see it for herself. Mm-hmm. And so rather than like just hear what we're saying, like once you get off this video, like you need to go see that for yourself, because, you know, you can say, oh, okay, I understand a little bit better. Like is nobody can tell you what God is like.
Right.
You know, God is, it's no real words to describe, you know, who he is or how he is or how amazing he is. You know, like in church you hear it all the time. God is great. God is good. All of that. Like you hear those words, but you feel them when you experience him for yourself, you know.
And I've been learning this lately too. Mm-hmm. So you feel it, or you realize his goodness even more so when you're going through hard times. I would be going through things or like really personal things, and I would be upset because I'm like, God, why am I going through this? Like, we supposed to be here. Like, why am I going through this? Why am I struggling with this? Why am I in this situation? Why couldn't you just do this? Like, and I feel like he had to show me, like, I'm not just good when everything is going good. You know, like, are you gonna worship me, or do you see me as faithful even when everything looks crazy, or where it doesn't look like, you know, where it doesn't look like what you want it to look like? I can see, because of the experiences that I've had with him, that he's good and he will always be good regardless. There's no other place to put your heart in, or that you can really entrust your heart to, other than the hands of God. So
agreed.
Jesus. Okay, you may be listening to us and you're like, I want to experience that. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. So when this video is over, click exit.
Word.
Literally, go into your bath, wherever it is. Grab your Bible. Mm-hmm. And talk to, and say, God, like, I want to know you. And it's like, God is faithful. Like, in his word, he says, call on me and I will answer. Mm-hmm. Seek me and you will find me.
He will.
Draw close to me and I will draw close. He's there. He's yeah. like... Ready.
That's probably the best one now. Draw near to me and I'll draw near to
right.
you. That one is true.
That's it. That's so it. True. Like, you take one step, God is like 4 steps in your face, does. Ready to pour out his love and to show you who he is. So it's like, oh, it's so great.
Make sure you have people around you who you want to get close with God. Make sure you have people around you who want to get close with God. Not people who just go to church, but people who are actually seeking Him, because it's only going to make you stronger.
Right. And if you don't have that, pray for them.
For real.
Pray that God gives you them. He would, like, it's as simple as that. Like, God, I want more of you, and I want to be around people who want you just as much and who are going to edify me and who are going to draw me close to you. And God wants that for you. So it's not like you're asking Him for anything crazy or out of His will. Like, God wants you to be surrounded by other believers, because that's such a huge part of it. Like, and especially because there's so many things in this world that's completely contradictory to God and the Bible and the Word of God. So if you are not surrounded, or if you're not, like, constantly, consistently, intentionally pursuing Him and around people who do the same thing and who want the same thing, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. So
it is.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. We hope that it blessed you in some type of way, and don't forget to check out Damon's YouTube channel, GTR TV.
Check that out.
Why are you so extra?
It's a good channel.
It's a great channel. His show Vlog City. He literally vlogs every single day.
Oh my gosh, it's so good for my faith, because I literally don't know what I'm going to be talking about to people every day. So it takes all of the pressure off of me.
Yeah.
So I'm like, I don't know. So he'll tell me what he wants to talk about. I'm like, all right, that's on you. It takes away a lot of pride too. So like, when people are like, oh, this is a good message, I was like, I didn't really play that much of a part in it. Like, aside from being used to say it, you know, it really all comes from Him. The word really comes from Him. Like, I like doing stuff really creatively. And if you'll see, like, if you watch the vlog, everything else is shot really creative. And then the end part where I give the message is super just one shot simple, because I don't want what I do to overshadow what it is that He has to say. And I don't want to be like, oh, I want to put this, and I want to put a funny part right here, and I don't want to do any of that. I just want you to, like, I think it was Paul who says, like I didn't come to you with like fancy
speech.
Oh, yeah, none of that. I put the power of God. So I want that part to be just power of God. You know, whatever you get is from Him. And all the other stuff, you're like, oh, cool angles. Like, that's me.
Yeah.
The other part is Him. You
know? Yeah, so definitely check that out. I'll post the link down below so that you can just click on it and you can subscribe and you can watch and you can do all that stuff.
Come through.
So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Oh, you gotta do that. Hey guys, this is Safina. If you are watching the King's Love Convo. Why are you so petty?
I'm sorry.
Hey guys, this is Safina. Can you
Safina,
grow up?
Safina, get it right.
Can you grow up?
All right, go ahead.
King's Love Convo.
On her channel fire.
It is.
You know what I'm saying? Pride comes before the fall.